the fabulous panorama of one of the most glamorous and exciting achievements in the commercial retail world, the local mall, all of life's social rites of passage take place. Your first paycheck, your first kiss, and opening your very own business, all of it happens at the Galleria. Continental Galleria is overflowing with all the regular drama, romance, ambition, young love, and villainy. Set to the backdrop of pure capitalism, style, fashion, and of course, cinnamon rolls and corn dogs. Yes, at the mall, everything that makes life worth living in love, worth loving, laughter, worth laughing. Everything is there, because it all happened at the Galleria. Now it's time to meet the regulars, the Continental Galleria. If you're visiting the Galleria for the first time, be sure to check in with this man. He is going to help you on your way in, on your way out, and every time in between. He's
Brad Lambert.
Yeah!
She works at the Corn Dog Utopia, and she steals from everywhere else. And if you're not careful, she'll steal your heart. She's
Sam Lambert.
Are you going to the prom, getting married, trying to create a new you? Then get the hands-on customer service of Carl Sanders.
Or Tommy Kelly.
To get the latest hairstyles from generalized Europe, be sure to stop by the Good Head Salon and see
Sebastian. This is Carl. That's Jenny Kelly.
Let's see Jenny one more time, because you'll be sure to want to see her when you want a more traditional, less sexually harassing stylist. Look no further than
Jenny Kelly!
There she is! She loves the spotlight. Next is service with a smile. She's always pleased to dish out a big helping of samples and judgment. She
Enid Nicodemus. Yay!
The owner of the mall, you should be sure to stop by and meet him. His grandfather built this mall, but now he's gonna run it right into the ground. He's
Wally Pip.
Wally has a son who hates him dearly for his capitalistic ways of life. This young gentleman is more interested in the ways of death. He's
Trevor.
You're probably more familiar with the Westfield Shopping Center, which is right across the street from the Galleria. Meet the owner himself, Mr. Desmond Westfield. You get the hang of it. Lastly, they guard the Galleria at night, and they clean it at night, and during the day they shop there like everyone else. There, the black shirt. We begin with a typical day at the Galleria. Brad Lambert's wandering the halls, looking for somebody to help. When, wouldn't you know it, he stops someone from stealing. And won't he be surprised to see who it is?
Hi, hey, welcome to the Galleria. Any help? Good? Cool. If you need me, just call. Alright, Brad. My name's Brad. You guys need any help? You good? No. Stores? I know it all. Anyone need any help at all? Hey, come on. Does anyone want to know the history of the Galleria?
Yes.
No.
Well, someone did. Sam! Open that jacket.
Why? I don't have anything in here.
That's from the store! I knew that wasn't your jacket. Take it off.
Brad, that's where shit comes from, the store.
You didn't buy it. Take it off. What are you doing?
You're my brother. It's weird if you undressed me.
You've got clothes underneath, okay? Boy, I am shocked. You work here. This is the Continental Galleria. This is our bread and butter, and you're stealing.
They don't pay me enough as a corn dog utopia, okay? I just need more stuff like this. Like, where else am I gonna get a rad coat like this?
You know, I can make you a coat. I can weave. If you need me to, I will.
You're such a tool.
Why are you stealing, Sam?
Because it makes me feel good. In a way that Mom and Dad never have. Stealing provides me with the love and an attention that I need.
But I'm a bro, huh? You're broski.
Ew.
Huh? I love you, huh? Come on, champ.
No.
You want to teach them one day, huh?
No.
Is that where Steve?
No.
Is that where
Steve? I will punch you in the face.
Don't do it.
I will.
I'll tell Mom.
Finally, she might pay attention to me.
Take off that jacket. Is that what this is about, huh? Come on, sit down. Sit down. Let's talk. Huh? Let's talk, huh?
I just want somebody to love me. You know, like Mom, or Dad, or Trevor, Enigma, Pip.
Trevor, Enigma?
He's this goth kid that I go to school with. He's so hot. His eyeliner comes out to here in a cool design.
My little sister's in love.
Have you ever been in love, Brad?
Yeah?
I mean, with something other than the mall.
Oh! Yeah. You know, the mall is my first love. In fact, I love someone that works here. The Galleria.
Oh, Wally Pip!
Not Wally Pip, I'm not gay.
Are you serious?
I keep telling you.
Speaking of Wally Pip, he's at his office managing the mall when he gets a surprise visit from his son's principal with his son and some very bad news.
I hope we make it.
Going to work in your jammies?
Dad, come on, that's what they wear.
They?
We?
You never used to wear them. Stuff on your face before your mom died.
Well, perhaps if you didn't kill her.
Excuse me?
Oh!
You know that you killed her, Dad. She was wasting away in the hospital of cancer. All you had to do was visit her a few times. But no, you couldn't. You were too busy running the mall. I hate you!
Sebastian showed up.
Hands are sweaty.
sweaty to unperm and unwrinkle every...
This is weird. I just came here to get a suit for my uncle died. He's in a black suit, and I don't think this would...
Name?
Michael's name?
Your name.
Oh, Bruce.
Bruce. Come over here in front of the mirror.
God, they're everywhere.
End scene.
Oh. That was coming.
Promises hands-on service, and he means it. Enid Nicodemus is passing out samples in the mall's thoroughthrough. When one Desmond Westfield comes by to scout out the competition.
Take a look outside. It's the mall.
That's right.
Grand Granddaddy built this mall.
Peter Pip. Peter Pip.
Peter Pip.
Built the mall.
And that fountain right there.
The Lewis and Clark Fountain, I know very well.
Okay. What else do you know about the Lewis and Clark Fountain?
What else do I know about the Lewis and Clark Fountain? Well, Mr. Pip, I know exactly why we built it there. Travel back with me in a time long forgotten about, the time of yore, when Lewis and Clark were traveling across the country, trying to find the Now, a little known fact, Mr. Pip, is that Lewis and Clark went north a little bit at one time, and they came up all the way over here. They realized they were lost, and they moved on back. They kept going across the country. But this is the spot that Lewis and Clark stopped at. That's why we have the fountain.
And
hunted bears. back.
Of course, everyone knows that trivia. It's a well-known story around the Galleria. Carl Sanders is at the food court when he sees Jenny there. He also has tickets to the Lady Gaga concert.
Two chicken bowl. Ready.
Everywhere we could also brush boobs nonchalant. Trevor, Enigma Pip is protesting the mass murder of various animals that go into corn dogs. When, who would you know works at the corn dog stand but Sam Lambert?
No, you're totally right. Don't buy these corn dogs.
No, don't buy these corn dogs.
Fuck corn dogs.
Fuck corn dogs! They're an establishment corn dogs!
Damn the man and his corn dog! Hi.
Hi.
So you ended up coming in the mall for summertime after all.
Well, I said, Sam, that, you know, I might make my way to the mall, and, you know, my dad owns it and all, so...
Yeah, I mean, I didn't take a job here just so I'd run into you.
No, why would I think that?
I don't know, why would you? I can work later, I'll just come back. Nobody's buying corn dogs right now anyway, thanks to you.
Well, then, I did my job, didn't I?
Speaking of jobs, oh wow, you work at Hot Topic, the greatest store in the world.
No, it's the greatest store ever.
I stole my shoes from there.
I thought they looked familiar.
Yeah. Oh, yours have purple laces.
Well, white is so normal.
Oh. I thought that white had become so normal that wearing them was, like, abnormal.
Well, just in you saying that, the abnormality of your statement is just so gauche.
Well, I'm 17 and I don't know what gauche means.
Touché.
I don't know what that means either.
Sam, I want to love you, but you're a little too strange for my taste.
What? You're a goth kid, and it's 2009.
All good questions. Brad is still working the floor at the mall, greeting people coming in and going out. When Sebastian Wela comes up with plenty of love advice for Brad's crush that he recently just confessed to, and it's not on Wally Pip.
Hey, welcome to Mall, Continental Galleria. Thumbs up from this guy. Loving it already. All right, cool. Welcome to the mall. Hi, how's it going? Sebastian! Hey, what's up, man? What's up, dog? How's it going? I guess your hands are full.
I'm eating a muffin. You don't even have to pay, you just get.
They're samples.
You like your job?
Yeah!
Happy man.
Like, sure as heck flyer I am, working at the Continental Galleria, best mall around.
Who do you talk to when you do this?
Just a thing I do. I'll stop it.
Are you gay? Are you a man that like boys? Do you like gays?
Why does everyone think that? I'm not gay. No.
I'm just asking.
No, I'm not gay.
It's okay, you don't have to be defensive.
In fact, I'm in love.
I got the extra ticket for Lady Gaga.
I'm not gay.
You don't have to be gay to like Gaga.
I don't know if I'm comfortable going anywhere.
It is good. We go, my cousin Hakbish goes there, he knows a guy, we get in, we go to the front, I got the backstage passes, you meet some girls, it'll be fun, you'll meet the bondings.
Sebastian,
it's better if I read American anyways, because then it feels like I have cultural stuff.
You seem to know a lot about women, huh?
I know lots about women. Ask me a question, I can tell you about women.
Well, kind of fancy someone that...
What do you mean, fancy?
That means I like.
Okay, sis.
Someone that works here, and...
Okay.
How do I tell her?
I have I pretend to be you, you be the girl, and I tell you how I used to do it.
Yeah. Yeah. Seems a little backwards, but alright. No, this is all right. Me.
So I'm you. Harold, I know a lot about the mall. Hey! What is that?
Harley, you look. You're eating that muffin really well.
I like to be eating your muffin.
Desmond Westfield stops in to having a good hair day salon. He also has tickets to the Lady Gaga concert that's tonight.
I'm just passing out cinema muffin samples. I have one left.
the one that Desmond Westfield bit into earlier.
He what?
Oh.
He bit into my sample.
Oh!
Holy! You're violent, Miss Cinemuffins!
That bastard was here?
Well, yes, he's my friend, and he kind of reminds me of Vernon and Jesus, all wrapped into one.
Oh!
What about me? We almost went to the prom.
That was in high school, Wally. Really? I mean, I am very grateful for the job that you gave me here at the Cinnabon. And I do so love being at the mall around all the young people. It makes me feel alive again since my husband passed away.
Oh, the smell. Old spice.
Sugar and cinnamon?
Yeah, but...
And Old Spice. It's Vernon's. I wear it all the time.
I smell that bastard, Westfield. I smell him.
Are you sure it's that holy water from church this morning?
Enid, I thought you and I were gonna go somewhere.
Well, we can go wherever you want, Wally. I do owe you one. Getting me this job now.
Not now. I don't even know if I want you in my mall.
What? What? No! Wally, no! Wally! Oh, don't make me get down on my arthritic knee! Wally! Jesus, that hurt! Oh, I swore! Oh, Wally! Wally, I need this job. Ever since... Oh, God! That knee replacement was really painful, Wally. You know that. And now I need to work at the mall to pay off my medical bills, and ever since Vernon died,
there's
no way I can get by without you. Please.
If you...
I beg of you.
I forbid you to see him!
Desmond?
Yes!
That's impossible!
Oh, help me up. Here. Help me up, Wally. Oh, okay.
Come here, sweetheart.
Oh, Desmond. Oh! You're so young and strapping, Desmond.
Why don't you bring your muffin tray and take a walk with the old across the street?
Oh, okay.
We're gonna have a talk about your future employment.
Here's your muffin, Desmond.
Have a nice day. Yep.
Take a bite.
We see Sebastian and Brad and Sebastian's cousin Hot Beef at the Lady Gaga concert. Enigma out into the forest behind the mall.
I'm sorry I compared you to Fallout Boy. It was wrong of me.
Sam Lambert, I can't figure you out.
I guess you could say I'm like an enigma.
You make me want to die quicker.
You make me want to make out. That's it. I've never even made out with anybody. Do we have to get so intellectual? I think you're hot.
Well, Sam, I think you're hot too, but alas, if I were to give in to your feminine wiles, it would lead nothing to us having sex all the time, day in and day out on our break and...
In the closet underneath the janitor's closet?
And underneath the janitor, Sam, yes! Yes, underneath the janitor, that's what I'm talking about!
I don't know, I've never had sex before! Oh God, nobody knows that. I told everybody I lost my virginity in the dressing room of the Forever 21, but... But the truth is, I've never had anything inside of me. God, why do you have to come out here? You don't even smoke.
What's going on here? What do you want inside of you, Sam?
The love of God, that's all.
Sam, I don't think you've introduced me to your brother.
This is my brother, Brad. The tool.
Brad, I'm not a tool.
Brad, I've seen you at the mall greeting people.
And you're Enigma. And I gotta say, things are a little fishy here. You guys hang out in the woods.
It's what the cool kids do, Brad.
You're right, Brad. Perhaps we should go back to the mall.
Yeah, I think we should go back to the mall.
I'm not really sure which way the mall is. Perhaps you should show me which way it is.
Oh, what are you kids doing in my forest?
We were just going back to the mall.
Well, hey, let's go back to the mall.
And,
I just peed myself.
Oh, God.
Well, that happened adjacent to the mall. Wally Pip goes to buy himself a new suit to cheer himself up.
Why, you are looking fantastic, sir. No, you, sir, with the hat.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, sir. No. What is your name?
Corden.
Corden, may I picture you on my wall?
Absolutely.
The mirror. Fantastic, sir. It's okay. I felt that negativity from across that sales room. A very dark, dark insideness from the side of the room. What is it, Wally? What is your problem?
I don't even know where to begin. My son thinks I'm old and I killed my wife.
Happens.
My would-be girlfriend from high school walked off with Westfield.
Why? You sound like you need a new suit. The summer edition, Versace.
Leather vest. Take off your jacket. Wally, trust me. You will feel like a new man. You're busting out, Wally. Why, you are busting out. Wally, you are busting out.
Wally, I was just coming to tell you that I... Oh, Jesus, pray for us all. You're no. Gay.
Finally, Brad returns from his voyage into the forest to see Desmond, who also offers him a great deal of satisfaction and a new job possibility. Will Brad transfer malls?
Bradley, my boy.
Oh, Mr. Desmond Westfield. How's it going?
Good, these benches were not made for lounging, Bradley. Listen, I got a proposition for you. I'll cut to the chase.
Yes, sir.
You really want to work in this mall?
Sir, Mr. Westfield, this is the best job I ever had.
Little trivia, Bradley. Who designed this mall?
Wally Pip.
Wally Pip? Why yes. Did he put a janitor's closet underneath another janitor's closet?
Because he was an equal opportunity employer who hired large janitors and midget janitors. It's all in the manual.
Bradley, you cannot.
He opened doors.
Have to keep little people on the ground. That is not how it operates.
He didn't do it maybe in the right way, but he still employed them.
At our mall,
the Westfields never employed a midget.
Oh, you gotta say something bad about the Westfields now. Bradley, I didn't come here to make enemies.
Didn't?
I came here to make friends.
All right. Make friends.
No, Bradley, I don't know if I want to do that now.
Well, I just got into the Lady Gaga's and we're having another concert tomorrow.
What are you talking about? It's not a plural, it's a one woman, Bradley.
She's all over the place.
Listen to me.
What?
You can work in this mall for the next, oh, I don't know, 45 years and end up broken, hopeless. Or you can come work for the Westfields, or better yet, you can tell me the little plan I've been working on. See, Bradley, this mall is kind of run down.
Yeah.
It smells a little like children when they've been left in the car a little too long. If you know what I'm
I've noticed that, yes.
How would you like to see a big old Westfield sign above this Galleria?
But the Galleria is so steeped in history and lore.
Oh, but things got to change, Bradley. Things have got to change. Now look with me to the future, Bradley. See the Westfield Mall. See the new history. Not Lewis and Clark with an empty fountain. How about Bradley? Bradley, settle here and talk to the people about Malden.
Well, why do you want me all of a sudden?
Because I see fire in your eyes, Bradley. Fire. Walk with me. I want to talk with you, Bradley. We're going to start a new future. Westfield and Bradley. Westfield.
Oh, this is a pickle.
You just follow me, Bradley, if you feel so inclined.
Well, maybe I'll check it out a little bit. Bradley Westfield does sound kind of nice.
Will Bradley change his last name in order to take a new job? Will Enigma and Sam ever get together? Will Wally Pip ever win anything? Find out next week when it happens all again at the Galleria!